guys, we're here for some. Welcome back to my FIFA 17 Westerlo career mode. Well, last time I left off, I picked up another 2 wins. Continuing my good form with the Belgian side. And I have to be honest, I'm actually surprised at how good this team is playing. Now, oh yes, someone pointed out to me that players play as good as you play with them. My friend, says you can use a team of overpowered players and still will be dead and terrible if you aren't good. Good. But if you could be good with a team of average players there's people would dismiss is if you are good at what you do. And I agree with that. I think that is a really good way of looking at it. Because I've used Jack Butler. Everyone says he's overpowered on the team, but for me, he was useless. Like, in the last episode, my goalkeeper almost made a huge mistake that luckily didn't result in me conceding a goal, or else he wouldn't even be in goal from being in this match. But luckily, my defender came to his rescue and saved the keeper's career. But Jack Butland did that all the time. He always palmed it. He never claimed it. He always palmed it, or parried it, or did something that resulted in the ball going to the opposition player in the ultimate team. And they would, 9 times out of 10, they would score. I'm like, Bowman is terrible. And now, yes, I can't really blame that on him, but at the same time, I can. Because, I mean, I didn't tell him to do that. I wasn't controlling Bowman. You want to control the keeper? Or when he has the ball, or if it's a goal kick. I can't control him when it's time to make a save, even unless I press the touch pad thing on the PlayStation 4, like so. Now I can control the keeper as if I'm playing player career mode.
But, tight and make sure they defend that clean sheet.
I don't like doing that because that camera, for one, I like the camera as it is, normal, as if I'm actually he watching a game of football.
The work of the players and the effort that they put in on the training ground, the manager's got.
On the camera. Follows the action. Lord knows it would be just as bad if I was watching from my actual avatar's perspective, because he's down here somewhere, or around where those two red dots are on the team sheet there. They're in the middle of the pitch. He's there by the where the technical area is. If I had to play this game, imagine if you had to play this game from like that perspective, you could get nowhere quick unless you were quick to adapt. Like that would take some time to get used to. For as long as I remember, I've used this particular. for camera. Yeah. And it's always it's the default. Yeah.
Gonna try one now. Very good stop here.
Yeah. The YouTuber that I watch all use this camera. Hang on. Won't they use something similar to it? Get to the point where you wouldn't even notice the difference. But I can't imagine how it would be unbelievably difficult to play this on something you weren't used to. But going back to good players and bad players, it's really down to who is controlling. I mean, I could have a team of absolutely scrubs on my team. And I think I could still easily unbelievable feats.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
Sorry, just had a pondering idea. I don't mind me. Actually, is a really interesting idea.
Attacking well here. Good pass. Getting it forward.
Penalty.
It's a penalty here.
City challenge. You go in the book now. I don't know why I'm talking like that.
It's a great chance for this side to stick one in the net. And
is this the first penalty? I think this might be my first penalty that this team. Oh, it's just gone in. Is that the first penalty I've taken at this club? I didn't even know who my penalty taker was. I'm pretty sure that's my center back. I'm pretty sure that is my center back. Yeah, number 3, that's my center back. That's the 71 rated dude, but who's retiring at the end of the season. And if I'm not mistaken, his name starts with D. Oh, I can't freaking remember it. Dams. Bleep Dams. I'm almost certain. Yeah, he is. He is indeed. His arm. Look at that. 37 years old. He has 85 penalties? He has as good as that. He's the best players in the world. Well, and he's a center back.
3-0.
What? I'm saying that I didn't know David Alaba was good about this until I signed him for Liverpool.
He's certainly been an influence on this first half.
I mean, I've used Alaba before, to be fair. But I never paid any attention to his penalties. That's the first one.
Might not be too much of a contest left.
I can't remember any others. No, I think that's the first one. And I was only looking to score it. But hey, 1-for-1. If that is the first one, I think it is. Maybe I got one in preseason.
He might be through. And here's the shot. Was he going just too far?
I'm saying that if I did, I would know who the penalty taker was, because none of these guys were on international duty during the preseason. Everyone here was mostly with me throughout the preseason, except for Harry, who missed only the first game. So he wasn't injured at all. When I say preseason, I mean the preseason tournament.
Trying to get it wide, and it was a good idea, but he couldn't find his supporting player. And the manager's decided.
Sorry if you hear me drinking water. Oh, it's at it again. And it was the same thing as the last.
That's a turnover to the opposition.
I don't know what's wrong. Okay. I guess it's that time of year again.
Substitution in the offing. Not rushing it here. Moving from one side to the other. Shots on here. So we've got a corner coming up.
Do want to be careful. You give away another penalty. And Dames will step up again.
Well, we're two-thirds of the way through the 90 minutes. Half an hour to go. On the attack here. Made the challenge well. He's given possession away here. This attack got a bit of menace to it.
Gamboa.
Any danger to the goal has gone with that clearance. Twenty minutes of the 90 still to play. Tackle here. Could be dangerous.
Gamboa.
And now the shot. He's kept it.
Off.
Corner kick coming up.
Dames! I'm probably saying his name wrong, but... I don't care.
Because they obviously have still got it. Well, he's having to work hard to do that.
Yes. He's powerful. Okay. That's what Gamboa was. Is it on goal? Oh, back to Highland! 4-0. England going so well in this group. And in the last episode, he did indeed.
Rightly so, well in the lead.
Asked the question on whether there is playoffs in the Pro League, because it's been so long since I did a career mode in the Pro League, I genuinely did not remember. But I was informed that indeed there is playoffs in the Pro League. I did look it up just to confirm that. Although I trust the person completely. Yeah, I don't know why they would lie to me. But it looks like I will have extra games. So finishing first is completely irrelevant. It's good to know the league actually fucking matters.
Goal! Well, sometimes you see the ball hit harder than that, but it's ended up as a goal. Well, a little look of celebration, but inwardly, he must be buzzing. Brilliant.
Well, if you put it on the spot like they did, it's going to end up in something like that. It's going to end up in a goal.
Five nil, and the game underway again.
Between Gamboa and Alpo, they are killing it. The two of them are going to be neck and neck come to the end of the season.
Tackle is strong.
I say the end of the season. This is only game 11. Not even halfway through the season yet. Well. we're almost halfway through the season. And I think that was Gamboa's 11th. I think Alpo's last goal put him on 12 or 13. Oh no, put him on 15. He's way ahead of that curve. And in the simulation to that last to the game, between now and the last episode, some guy handed in his transfer request. This guy, he handed in a transfer request, so I listed him, even though he's 25 years old, so there's that. But he has, his contract is running out, so he can leave for free in the summer if he wants. I'm probably not going to get a fucking dime for him come the January transfer window. I'll have to accept any offer that comes in immediately to prevent him from signing with another club. And get absolutely nothing for him. Better to get some bit of money, any kind of money whatsoever. Even if it's a slap in the face, it would be better than getting absolutely nothing. I mean, it was bound to happen. And I was fully prepared for it to happen, but I was a little confused. I was a little taken aback when he did hand in his transfer request, because I was like, okay, I knew this was gonna come, but truth be told, I didn't fully prepare for it. Now I'm wishing I did offer him a new contract when I had the chance. Because then the ball would fully be in my court. Because if I do not, like, considering his rating, a 67, now, I thought no one would sign, what's his name, from Marseille, at the end of the last FIFA. When he wanted to leave, I thought no one would sign him, but someone did. Someone actually came in with a bid for him. I thought, his ring, no one's gonna want him. But some of it, someone did come in for him. But it was really late in the window. But when that guy, hey, wasn't, I can't quite remember. He was either not old enough, or his contract was too long for him to sign on a pre-contract agreement. So anyone who wants him could just, you know, look him, have their scouts scout him. He's probably guys looking into him already. A lot of good coming to my games will do them, because he doesn't play. But, someone could easily say, oh, he's 25 years old, so he can sign pre-contract agreement because he's over the age of 23. He'll, when January rolls around, he'll have 6 months left on his contract.
That throw has literally tossed possession away.
And since he's transfer, they are transfer listing him, but that's clearly their attempt to get some kind of money. Okay. Let's just sign him on a free. All we'll have to do is pay his wages. We don't have to worry about a transfer fee.
Played down the wing, keeping the wide attack going.
Now, maybe I'll get a bid in from someone who will want him there and then. But, like, a team could look at that and say, I'm happy to wait the pier, wait it out. We'll get him on a free. He jumped on.
Good work from the referee. Well, this is a chance from the free kick. sliding in and taking his part in the game into a dangerous...
That would be especially delightful if...
And the first goal will be...
Wow. I put a player on the line to stop that from happening, and it still happened. My first goal conceded in freaking ages is not just in this career mode, in ages. I've been unbelievable with the amount of clean sheets I've been pulling out. Wait. Yeah, especially in secondary career modes. I'm not even mad, that's a fantastic free kick. Credit to Kea. I'll probably put during his name, but.
On the attack here. A timely challenge.
I mean, should I put a different player on the line? Would it matter? Was it just that good? Was that free kick just that good? Oh my gosh. Well. I should have conceded my first goal, but it due to a goalkeeping error in the last episode. But luckily I managed to avoid that. Not so on this occasion. A free kick I sloppily gave away. I take full responsibility. I didn't need to give that free kick away, but I did. It wasn't even one of those ones where you'd be like, what did I even do? I fully admit I did foul him. The yellow card was deserved, and the and they took full advantage of getting that free kick.
Through pass. Got the ball back.
And now something very very uncommon for me is I have to perform a comeback. I have to score two goals and get into the lead after being behind.
Nothing wrong with this. I mean, it's unstoppable, really. Top left hand corner.
Just went over his head. And I don't mean that in the, oh, it went over their head. Like, when you say something you shouldn't in front of like kids and they don't really understand you, and you say, hey, oh, it just went over their heads, or a joke that they didn't understand.
Well, take another look at this.
If he had met that, then this header would be the opening goal. Instead, it's the equalizer. Of a goal for Alpo for 16 for the season. I really don't know why to call him Alpo. Carlos Stenberg. Why do they call him Alpo? I don't know. That's what's coming up, so whenever he's on the ball, so that's what I'm calling him. I mean, I have no problem calling him by his normal name. Maybe if it bothers people. But if the game is putting that up, then I have free right to call him that. That's like people calling Rodriguez James, because that's what comes up for him. At least that's what came up for him last FIFA. I haven't used Rodriguez on this FIFA. He's on the proverbial list. And no, I won't say what I was gonna say. Maybe it's. Well, some people won't get it. They won't get the reference. Some people will, some people would have. But I won't say anyway. And anyone who would have gotten the reference may connect the dots of what I was gonna say.
Referee blows, and we're off for the second half.
took me 19 minutes to equalize. They scored their goal on the 17th minute. Mine came in the 36th. And a goal that puts me ahead from Alpo again. And comes in the 50th minute.
He is feeling that.
5 minutes into the second half.
Replaying over and over again, isn't it?
And that goal, is just a bad blemish.
Doing well to keep the ball. And shoots! He's made the save. Here's the chance. That's a good block. Well, he's taken a touch there of the defender. It will be a corner. Here's a replay again of the goal.
Well, he won't mind seeing it again because he's just smashed it. Bottom left, no chance for the keeper.
It's out for a goal kick. Beautiful. They miss. Mayans.
Into the attacking.
Come on, Mayans. Back. Or don't.
Go in now. Christensen. Yes, it's another throw here. Never quite as simple as you think to throw the ball to one of your teammates. Well, it will be a throw in. Highland. Through pass. And in goes the cross. Shots on here. Oh, charged down. Promising build-up until that challenge.
No, she's turned down.
Looking good, this move. Can they do it in these closing minutes?
It looks like the opposition is in for an aerial bombardment here.
This could be it.
Oh, they tried to take him over the stop him, mate. He continued on, and the keeper easily charges. Shot.
Didn't commit himself, stayed on his feet, asked the question.
Henry. Fans! Oh!
So the corner to come.
The defender clipped it for the corner anyway, and I wasted it. Brilliant.
Highland. On the attack here. That's a good idea with
the... Cavola! 3-1.
Fine moment for them. They've got a firmer grip on the game now. They're two ahead.
Yeah, pulls with those camera as because that puts some gap between me in this and Zolta Wargrim?
They're trailing, so an extra potential goal scorer brought on.
But I think he had to do it, didn't he? Not going to go down with a whimper. This manager wants to go down with a fight, and this is the right way to go about it.
Terrific tackle.
Oh, Highland. And he won the ball, but he immediately lost it back.
To saw the pass coming and got there first. Well, let's look at it again, Alan. It was very close and there would have been a scoring opportunity.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good position they fashioned themselves into there. And he did go a fraction of a second early. He was off.
And the ball has gone up to indicate 3 added minutes. Just 1 minute left on the clock. He's got to play it back to the goalkeeper.
They're that good. Nice and far up the pitch. And there's a fault on Muscle. Oh, is it? If this is... Hey, yeah, okay, I get it. What you're trying to do. There was no time left for a comeback. But, fair play to this team for becoming the first team to score against me in a long time, especially on the secondary for Uma. And it was a good enough goal that you can say fair play and not be overly pissed about it. Of course, I'll be keen for that not to happen again in the future episodes, but it's happened. It might have been bound to happen. I don't know. But yeah. Now we'll go into the next episode. And try to prevent it from happening again. Another transfer request. Jesus Christ. I'm going to have no players left if they all fucking want to leave. Who's this? Rice? He's 22. I don't particularly want to lose him. I'll figure it out off camera. Until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Bye bye.